Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the ternary search process. To use this process, first we have to make sure that the array is already sorted. And then we have to make sure that in the entire process, the low index has to be smaller than or equal to the high index, both of which will be discussed later. And we have to evaluate the two middle indices according to the low and high indices, and then we check if any one of the middle elements equals the target or not. If the element is on the left part, then we just handle the left part and update the high index. If we find that the element is on the right part of the array, we handle the right part, and it means that we have to update the low index. If the element is expected to be in the middle part, we just handle the middle part, and then we update both the low and high indices. And then we just continue steps 2 to 6 until our target is equal to one of the middle elements or until the low index is larger than the high index, which doesn't make sense. And then I have to tell you the way to calculate the indices. First, we have to indicate the low and high indices, which means that the smallest index and the largest index in the portion of the array of concern. And then we can find out the mid 1 and mid 2 indices. The mid 1 is equal to the formula on the bullet point 1. And we have to notice that we do integer division. So that's why I have two slashes to indicate integer division. Similarly, mid 2 is found by the formula on bullet point 2. Third, if the left part is to be retained, we just keep the low index unchanged, and the high index is equal to mid 1 minus 1. If the right-hand part is retained, we change the low index to mid 2 plus 1, and we keep the high index unchanged. 5. If the middle part is retained, we update the low index to mid 1 plus 1, and we update the high index to mid 2 minus 1. Now, let us see an example. Suppose I want to find number 7 from this array of sorted numbers. Since we have the new array, we just put low to be the far left index, which is 0 in this case, and high to number 9, which is the far right index. Since we have low, which is smaller than or equal to the high index, we can find out the two indices called mid 1 and mid 2. And we can see that mid 1 is equal to 3 and mid 2 is equal to 6, which are already shown on the slide. Now we see that the value corresponding to mid 1 is 13 and the value corresponding to mid 2 is 26. But now the target is 7. It just means that the target is smaller than values corresponding to mid 1. In this case, we select the left part and update the high index. Now, we update the high index as follows. We have to subtract 1 from mid 1 so that I have now 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2. And I also keep the low index unchanged. Since the low index is smaller than or equal to the high index, I can update mid 1 and mid 2 according to the formulas on the second slide of the presentation. So now I have mid 1 equals 0 and mid 2 equals 2. And in this case, I can ignore portions not including the low and high indices. Now we see that mid 1 corresponds to number 3 in my array and mid 2 index corresponds to 12 of my array. So we see that the target is larger than the mid 1 value and the target is also smaller than the mid 2 value. In this case, we don't select the right or left part. Instead, we select the middle part, and then we update the low and high indices. Now we see that the low index is changed to mid 1 plus 1, which is equal to 1, and high index is changed to mid 2 minus 1, which means 1 in my case. Since the low index is still smaller than or equal to the high index, I can update both mid 1 and mid 2 values. So now they both have 1 according to the formulas shown on the slide. And you can see that now in this case, all the low, high, mid 1 and mid 2 indices are equal to 1. So I can just constrain the interval of the investigation to just one value. And we can see that mid 1 corresponds to number 7 and mid 2 corresponds to number 7. So now we can see that the target is equal to values at mid 1, or at the same time, the target is equal to values at mid 2. And now we say that the target is found at index 2. Now, of course, the search is complete, and we can really find out the target from the given sorted array. Let us see another example. Suppose I want to find out 28 from the sorted numbers in this array. First, we have to indicate the low index and the high index. Low index now corresponds to the far left index, and the high index corresponds to the far right index, which is 9. Since the low index is smaller than or equal to the high index, we can evaluate mid 1 and mid 2 indices. So mid 1 is now 3 and mid 2 is now 6 according to the formulas. And we see that mid 1 corresponds to 13 and mid 2 corresponds to 26. Now we have the condition that the target is larger than 26 because the target is this 28. It means that we select the right hand part. We also have to update the low index accordingly. Now the low index is changed to mid 2 plus 1, which is equal to 7 in my case, and also I keep the high index unchanged. After the update of the high and low indices, we just handle the right hand part of the entire array. Since in this case, low is still smaller than or equal to the high index, we can continue to update my mid 1 and mid 2 indices accordingly. So now mid 1 is 7 and mid 2 is 9. And we check that mid 1 corresponds to 29 and mid 2 corresponds to 34. And we find that the target is smaller than the value at mid 1 index. So in this case, we just select the left hand part and update the high index accordingly. So I just keep the low index unchanged, and high index would become mid minus 1, which is equal to 7 minus 1. So now high is 6. Now you can see that the high index is already outside the right-hand part that we focused on beforehand. In this case, we have the low index, which is larger than the high index. In this case, it indicates that the target cannot be found. So we stop the search. And that is the end of the entire search process. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions at the comments section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.